time. Okay, see you tomorrow.
Take it easy. And good afternoon, I'm Lexi Schultz. We'll give you the hottest news here and abroad. We'll also give you online feedback on news and issues from prominent personalities and you, our viewers. This is ANCAlerts. More petitions against the Cybercrime Prevention Act of 2012 are filed at the Supreme Court, this as the controversial law takes effect today. Malacañang, meantime, urges critics of the cybercrime law to speak out to their supposed allies, hackers who deface government websites. And later on in the program, we'll have a discussion on the UNICEF's online auction, which is part of its celebration of Children's Month. Another petition against a cybercrime prevention has been filed before the Supreme Court. Ina Reformina is there, and she filed this report.
This eighth petition was filed by faculty members of the Ateneo de Manila University College of Law, who are also at the same time members of the Ateneo Human Rights Center. In a 40-page petition for certiorari, Ateneo College of Law Dean Stephanie Candelaria and attorneys Mel Santa Maria, Amparita Santa Maria, Gilbert Sembrano, and Ryan Jeremiah Kwan assailed sections 4, 5, 6, 7, and 19 of the law for being patently unconstitutional and urged the Supreme Court to immediately issue a temporary restraining order to prevent the implementation of the question provision. Now, Section 4.4, which they're questioning, of course, criminalizes libel on cyberspace. Section 5 lists aiding or abetting in the commission of cybercrime and attempt in the commission of cybercrime as additional offenses under this law. Section 6 raises by one degree higher the penalties provided for by the revised penal code for all crimes committed with the use of information and communication. Section 7, which they're also questioning, provides that apart from prosecution under RA 10175, any person charged for this offense will not be spared from violations of the revised penal code and other special laws. And finally, Section 19, which they are questioning, authorizes the DOJ to block access to computer data. Of course, this is the controversial takedown powers of the DOJ. Petitioners said these provisions transgress the right to life, liberty, property, and equal protection of the laws, the right against unreasonable searches and seizures, the inviolability of the privacy of communication and correspondence, the freedom of speech, of expression, of the press, and the double jeopardy doctrine of the 1987 Constitution. All these rights, fundamental freedoms, and doctrines present in the 1987 Constitution. They also asked for the holding of oral arguments to better thresh out their positions on this case. Ina Reformina, ABS-CBN News.
Media groups are also taking a united stand against the Cybercrime Prevention Act. The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, Philippine Press Institute, and the Center for Media Freedom and Responsibility also filed a petition before the Supreme Court questioning the constitutionality of the law. Meanwhile, a blogger urges the public to participate in the crafting of the implementing rules and regulations of the cybercrime law. Speaking on ANC, Janet Toral, one of the petitioners against the law, said that public participation will ensure that the law does not encroach on the right to free expression and privacy.
Yes, that is the reason why the government wants to open the participation in drafting the IRR with the citizens, right, as much as possible, so that this can be carefully crafted. Mm-hmm. It is important for citizens to participate so that they can guard that provision. Yeah. Like for me, that provision is only okay for me if it's gonna take down anonymous sites. Mm-hmm. Because really, there's not, how can you fight something that is set up by someone anonymously, and then it really causes a lot of havoc and damage to people and harming a lot of people. Mm-hmm.
The cybercrime law aims to address online crime, but it seems to have spawned more online vandalism. Hackers continue to deface .gov.ph addresses online in protest of the cybercrime law. Members of the anonymous hacktivist group from various parts of the world launched a distributed denial of service or DDoS attacks on government websites, making them inaccessible to users. The operation, dubbed OP Philippines, disabled websites belonging to the Official Gazette, the Senate, and the National Bureau of Investigation. But the hackers are not stopping there. In a statement, the group announced that this recent attack, which is now considered as one of the biggest cyber attacks in the country's history, is not the last. In a statement published online, the group listed other targets, including a website belonging to Senator Tito Soto. Malacañang, meantime, urges critics of the cybercrime law to speak out against online vandalism and bullying. In a statement, the palace says that hackers who deface government sites are the ones who deprive the public of freedom to access government services, the same hackers who claim the cybercrime law threatens netizens' online freedom. The palace adds that it recognizes efforts to raise issues against the cybercrime law in court. It also welcomes amendments to the law. Malacañang asserts that concerned stakeholders have a chance to air their concerns when the Justice Department holds a dialogue on the matter. The Department of Science and Technology is unfazed by the recent attacks on various government websites. Undersecretary Luis Casambre of the DOSD's Information and Communications Office believes the hackers are merely exercising their right to express their view. Casambre adds that it may be humiliating to see the government's websites vandalized, but he would rather focus on apprehending the actual cyber criminals out there. Casambre also said fortifying security of each and every government system is more cost and time efficient rather than tracking these hackers. Casambre will be the chairman of the Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center, a new group mandated to oversee the implementation and policies surrounding the law. Senate Majority Leader Tito Soto admits he proposed the inclusion of the libel clause in the cybercrime law, but he denies it was a last-minute insertion. Soto says he pitched the online libel clause to the law's author, Senator Edgardo Angara, and the provision was approved in January without objection. Soto adds his proposal was not in retaliation to the cyberbullying that he received after his turno and contra speeches against the RH bill in August.
Hindi siningit. Yun ang sinasabi ko. Mali, pinadudumi nila yan. Sinisiraan na naman ako nitong mga ibang tao na ito na gumagamit ng ganong media. Na sinasabi, siningit ko lang dahil daw inaatake ko ng Agosto, September. Ano, ako ba yung mayroong bolang kristal? Na malalaman ko na ano na Agosto, September o atakihin nila ako. Hindi, siguro, divine providence. Binigyan ako ng pagkakataon na gano'n. Pero hindi, baliwala sa akin yun. Eh, ang ngayon nga, in effect na yan, hindi ko naman, wala naman akong chat-chat yan sa mga pagtatawanan ko lang yan at ika nga, Diyos na bahala sa kanila eh.
Soto adds he suggested the inclusion of online libel clause in the law last December due to online sex scandals and cyberbullying against celebrities. Soto cited the case of actress Rian Ramos, who drew online flack over scandalous allegations of her ex-boyfriend Mo Twister in a video clip posted on YouTube. Soto also cited sex scandals linked to actresses Maricar Reyes and Katrina Halili, as well as the leaked sex video showing actress Janelle Manahan with boyfriend Ramjen Revilla, who was killed last year. The sponsor and author of the Cybercrime Prevention Act says there's no need to panic over the law. Senator Edgardo Angara says that the fear over the cybercrime law is, in his words, self-created, adding that its disputed provision on online libel does not hinder freedom of expression. Although he defends the law, he also admits that it has flaws. Angara backs calls to amend the cybercrime law by requiring the Justice Department to get a court order before blocking data and lowering penalty for offenders. He also calls on the Justice Department to suspend the implementation of the law's takedown clause until the Supreme Court rules on the matter. Meantime, Senator Angara's son, Aurora Representative and senatorial hopeful Sonny Angara, believes the cybercrime law should be amended. Angara says lawmakers should listen to the public clamor and revise the widely opposed provisions of the cybercrime law. Angara believes there is still time to amend the law.
either House or Senate cannot really wash their hands of this. Mm-hmm. But the most that they can do at this stage is admit if they made a mistake and listen to the clamor of the people. Mm-hmm. So in that sense, kung nagkamali dito sa online libel, dapat magpakumbaba at be humble enough to say, guys, we messed up, we can correct this. Mm-hmm.
Just hours after releasing a statement on the cybercrime law, the palace has reposted the excerpts of the Senate deliberations on the cybercrime prevention bill. The excerpts, which are posted on the official gazette, collates talks on the Senate bill dating back from May last year. It also records amendments to the bill while it was in the Senate, as well as how the senators voted on third reading. The excerpts are also available on the Senate website, senate.gov.ph. Cyberbullying victim Christopher Lau welcomes the new Cybercrime Prevention Act. Speaking before the recent Social Good Summit, Lau said online abuse could damage reputations and cause emotional distress to victims, as the medium fosters a lack of accountability among users. Lau also opened up about his own painful experience with cyberbullying last year and how it made him fall into alcohol abuse and illness. Lau became the target of online ire after a TV news report showed him blaming other people when he drove his car into a flooded street last August 2011. His phrase, "I should have been informed," was mocked, and his name was a trending topic on Twitter. Instead of hitting the streets, several Filipinos resorted to wit, humor, and creativity as they created memes targeting the cybercrime prevention law. This after Facebook users went black on Tuesday as a sign of protest against the law, which criminalizes libel online. On Wednesday, blogs and websites such as 9gag were filled with anti-cybercrime-inspired memes, which may have been passed on from one social media account to another. Here's a mock Facebook login page that orients users on how they may be held liable and sent to prison for liking negative things. Another photo spoofs a quote from The Social Network and tweaks it to "You don't get to destroy the internet just because you can't handle criticisms." And finally, we have this meme called "Annoying Facebook Girl," which says, "Philippine politicians bullied, time for cybercrime law." Up next, we'll have a discussion on UNICEF Philippines' Auction for Action. This is ANC Alerts.
Ang malaking bahagi ng aking pinagdaanan, pinagdaanan din ng buong bayan.
Shared the power to arrest anybody.
Very brilliant man, but who happened to be on the wrong side of history.
He's been called tuta, demonyo, devil. Whatever names they call him, that is not Juan Ponce Enrile.
Sa aking pakikipagsapalaran sa buhay, marami akong nasaksihan, pinagdusahan, at ipinagdiwang.
Johnny, the Juan Ponce Enrile story. October 6, Saturday, 8 p.m. October 7, Sunday, 10 a.m. Here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel.
Tinitiis nila ang puhaw dahil sa kawalan ng malinis na tubig.
Medyo malabo-labo po siya.